If you are a busy professional who has been experimenting with Microsoft Copilot, you probably already know how it goes. Sometimes you get exactly what you need, while other times it gives you something totally off. And the main difference between the first situation and the second one is how you ask Copilot to do the work for you. In this video, I'll show you how to get the perfect prompt for Copilot so that you can consistently get useful and time-saving results that will help you be more productive at work and get that promotion or just free up some time for yourself in the evening. First, let's start with the basics. Microsoft recommends using the GCSE framework when prompting Copilot to get the best results. When using this framework, basically your prompt should include the following four components. First of all, a goal. What do you want Copilot to do? And here you can be direct. Just use action verbs like summarize, rewrite, draft, analyze. Basically, don't just say things like, please help me with this, but say exactly what you want. Next, you have the context. You need to give some background, maybe a file, a project name, a role, or a scenario. Basically, you want to help Copilot understand why you are asking, which will shape the tone, the focus, and the priorities when crafting the answer for you. Next, you have the source. Where should it pull information from? Is there a specific document containing the information, or maybe an email thread or a slide that Copilot should use? The more specific you are about the source, the more relevant the answer from Copilot will be. And finally, you have the expectations. How should the response look like? Are you looking for bullet points, maybe a table, an email draft? These essentially will help matching the output of Copilot to your needs for your work. So a basic example of this framework would be something like this prompt here. Analyze recent customer feedback, that's the goal, for our Q1 marketing campaign, that's the context, using this Excel file of survey responses, that's the source, and give me a summary of top complaints and suggestions in a table format. That's the expectation, which, as you can see, it's a much better prompt than just saying something like, take this file and let me know what are the top complaints. What you need to understand is that if your prompt is vague, Copilot has to make a lot of assumptions, and usually the assumptions that it will take will not necessarily line up with the output and expectation that you had in mind. So you need to tell Copilot exactly what you want it to do and use the GCSE framework with enough detail on each step to give the output that you want. But the question now is, how much information should I now add to the prompt? And you would think that the more the better, but actually that's not always the case. When it comes to prompting, clarity beats length. A longer prompt that is vague and it's rambling about a certain topic and going all around without a clear action will never be better than a concise prompt that tells exactly Copilot what you want it to do. So the key is not overloading Copilot with everything that you want it to do, but asking exactly what you want it to do and using the GCSE framework to structure that prompt so you can get the best out of Copilot. Now, let's dive into how much information is enough for each of the four components of the frame. For the goal section, one clear action is better than a long list. If you need multiple things, like let's say summarizing feedback and creating a slide deck from it, you can split the actions into separate prompts. Otherwise, Copilot will try to do too much at once and it will fail at both tasks. When it's about context, technically, you could give infinite information about the context around a certain task. But after practicing a lot, I found that usually you're fine if you include the who, like your role or the audience, the what, basically the task or the project, and the why. What is the output for? And typically, that's enough for Copilot to tailor the tone, the content, and the priorities without getting it overwhelmed. For source, you want Copilot to refer to one or two documents at most. And here, it's also important to understand how much Copilot can handle at once. When, for example, you want to summarize very large documents, you should keep documents to 80,000 words or less. If instead you're asking Copilot questions about a certain document, the best is to keep that document at 7,500 words or less. And if you want to ask Copilot to rewrite a certain document, the best is to keep that document to 3,000 words or less. That's, according to Microsoft, the optimal length for each of these tasks. But if your source file is longer than that, no worries. Later on, I have a tip on how to deal with such cases. Finally, for expectations, some sort of formatting cue is already usually enough. Like, for example, you can just mention make a list, or a slide outline, or two paragraphs. But you can also take it a step further and showcase the exact structure that you want Copilot to use in its answer. So let's say, for example, you are writing a job posting for your company and you usually have sections like who we are, what you will do, responsibilities, minimum requirements, and your benefits. you can include those section headers right into the prompt, which essentially is like giving Copilot a template to fill in for you. Now, once you're proficient into the GCSE framework, according to Microsoft, there is 4 more tips that can help you bring your results and your prompts to the next level. According to Microsoft, ordering the prompts matters. Copilot tends to emphasize the parts at the end of the prompt more than the parts at the beginning of the prompt. That means that what you might say last has more weight into the response that Copilot will give you. And let's say, for example, that you want Copilot to work with a very specific file and make sure it refers to that file, you might want to try putting that at the end of your prompt. Let's take an example. You could, for example, say, summarize the attached Q2 performance report for our leadership team, focusing on customer retention metrics and churn rate trends. Please format the output as 5 bullet points. Or you could say, use 5 bullet points to summarize customer retention and churn trends from the Q2 performance report. This is for our leadership team, so highlight only key takeaways and performance insight. Even though these two prompts contain the exact same piece of information, the order is different, and you will see that the answer that Copilot gives you will also be different depending on which order you have used. So don't be scared to experiment, try different orders, and see which one works best for the action that you want Copilot to take at that moment. Next tip is using positive instructions. Copilot is designed to take action, so it's better to give instructions telling it what to do rather than telling it what not to do. So for example, instead of saying, don't make this text too technical, you should try something like, write this in plain language that a non-technical audience can easily understand. The third tip is breaking it down when you're working with long documents. If you are working with a very long document, like I explained before, Copilot might not be able to take everything at once. But that doesn't mean you cannot use Copilot at all in such cases. You still have a couple of options on how to use long documents along with Copilot. On one side, you could break the document into sections. So you just split up the document into logical parts, and you can prompt Copilot separately for each of the different parts. Another alternative is to summarize in parts. So let's say you're working with a really long document, you could ask Copilot to first summarize a certain specific part of that document, then summarize another part, and so on, until you have a few summaries of the document. And finally, you can ask Copilot to take all those summaries and make a concise, unified summary that takes into account the entire document, so you have one final output summarizing the entire document. Finally, when you're using Copilot to do more difficult tasks, like for example, a market research or some strategy work, you will get better results if you follow a multi-layer prompting approach than having just one big ask. So usually, you would like to start with prompts that keep everything really broad and then narrowing it down, taking different steps until you reach the desired output that you want. For example, let's say you're a product manager at a tech company and you are working on your next camera and you need help to define the set of features and how to market them. You might want to break down the task like this. First, you start with something really broad, mapping the landscape. You can use a prompt like, please provide a detailed overview of the current industry of pocketable cameras for blogging and content creation, including major players and key market trends. Here, you start with a really broad question around the industry, which sets the stage for the more detailed questions that you're gonna ask next. Second, you can go deeper with, for example, conduct a competitive landscape analysis on the major players in the pocketable camera market. Focus on their strengths and weaknesses, as well as their target audience and the different strategies they follow. So here you've gone a level deeper, focusing directly into competition. And this allows you to understand where you are in the market, which is crucial to understand how your proposition will look like next. As a third prompt, you can go a level deeper with something like, I'm a product owner at Insta360, for example, and based on the analysis you just did, provide actionable insights and recommendations on how our product can gain a competitive advantage in the pocketable camera market. Consider areas like feature differentiation, pricing, and target market segment. Now here you're going a level deeper and you're asking for insights that you can apply to your specific product. And last but not least, you can finish with a prompt like, craft a differentiation strategy for our pocketable camera, focusing on how our camera outperforms competitors in the areas you identified earlier. Include the customer pain points and how the features you just highlighted address them. By layering your prompts, this feels more like a dialogue that you're having with Copilot, which it allows it to generate answers built on what it has generated already before, rather than trying to guess everything at once. So there you have it. By following a clear structure, focusing on the right details, and following the strategic tips that I just showed you, you can basically make sure that Copilot can help you in any task, from the most simple one to really strategic ones. I hope you find this video very useful. If so, please drop a like and let me know in the comments. I make sure to read them all, and I'll see you next time. Bye.